I'm Thomas Hartle. I'm the first Canadian to receive legal access to psychedelic-assisted psychotherapy in Canada. I received a Section 56 exemption in 2020 and was able to get access to a therapy that really had incredible benefits to my quality of life. I am a terminal cancer patient, so end-of-life distress is something that I deal with on a fairly constant basis. And psychedelic-assisted therapy is something that has really been a game-changer for me in terms of being able to restore my quality of life and help me deal with the type of dread that I have on a daily basis. Now, unfortunately, the exemption that I had expired 1 year after it was issued, as is the case with everybody in Canada who has been able to access it through that program. And in the year since I have reapplied for that, I have not been able to get access to that program through the government of Canada. So unfortunately, people like myself have been forced to look for other options. And the option that I have found that is available is here in Jamaica, where I am currently sitting with Nick Murray, who is here at Wake Hill Retreat. And they have a psilocybin-assisted therapy program here that Nick has been very good to allow me to get access to. I will let Nick introduce himself and tell you a little bit about the program that they've got here.
Thank you, Thomas. I'm Nick Murray, founder and CEO of Wake Network, and we're really working towards providing naturally occurring psilocybin that is pharma-grade and is able to be consumed in a safe environment and comes with a safety profile that is lab-tested. What we've been working with Thomas on is really providing access for those in need to be able to access psilocybin safely and ethically and very cost-effectively, so that it's not something that's cost-prohibitive or takes a long time to be able to access. We wrap the program in more than just psilocybin. There's pre-integration, post-integration, and some other health modalities that help really integrate the natural forms of psilocybin into their everyday life and really try and work towards a better path. So we've been really grateful to have both Thomas and his wife here down in Jamaica, and we hope that it's the first of many. This is something that we're really proud to be partnering with Thomas on, and hope that we can have many more North Americans come down and really receive the treatment that Thomas has experienced.
I appreciate you mentioning that my wife is actually here with me. There have been a number of people who have been able to get access to psychedelic therapy in Canada, but the majority of them tend to be people with terminal illnesses just like myself. And the unfortunate truth is that a lot more Canadians than just terminal people are having difficulties dealing with these same type of anxiety and depression sort of situations. And my wife, who has been right there with me and has been exposed to the same end-of-life trauma that I am myself, has been able to benefit from the therapy down here. And she would never be able to get access to that in Canada because it is still a controlled substance. So Canada used to be a place where they were very at the forefront of a lot of this research, looking into this. And places like here in Jamaica are now the ones that are now leading the pack in terms of being able to provide this type of healing to not just terminal people like myself, but to their families as well. Katie, I know you are somebody who is also involved in offering programs that are helping people who are not just terminal patients like myself.
Yeah, I'm Katie Walker. I'm a provider in the United States, and I have a company that I'm the CEO of called Revitalist. And really what we want to do is, we're working with Wake, is to help provide timely access to quality care and making sure that everyone's safe. And then also to be able to integrate different service lines to provide the most support possible. So Nick's able to provide the psilocybin piece in Jamaica, and then we're able to really work virtually and in person with different types of integrative therapies to where we can really support the whole person, right? So it's the emotional, spiritual, mental, physical health, just to allow that person to thrive. Thomas's situation is very unfortunate, but it's why we're all here, to advocate for him and to help to empower others as well. Thomas fortunately does have financial resources to help him to get down here. And that's something that we really want to work towards, is to help provide as much access as possible to individuals. But fortunately too, Thomas has, you know, a wonderful team, to where, you know, Nick's able to provide all of this safety with the product, but then also Dr. Green and myself are able to provide a lot of the, you know, just the holistic safety aspects as well. So it's something that's necessary. It's unfortunate because it's really an ethical issue. Not allowing individuals to have access to this, you know, really across the world. So it's something that we're all advocating for, and we're just ethically aligned to push forward to allow more access so individuals can, you know, they can really transition to whatever state they need to be in for a higher quality of life, but then also their family units can transition as well. And it's, you know, it's about healing the spirit and the body and the mind.
I appreciate that you you have mentioned the integrative component of that. It's a lot more than just taking some psilocybin mushrooms and everything is all better. The team down here is really focused on not just taking care of things like anxiety, but helping you to move forward with that, with things like the mindfulness and the spiritual component as well. Riley here has been very instrumental in that part of my particular journey.
Yeah, you know, I strongly believe in psilocybin mushroom therapy, and it's going to be an amazing healing tool, and as well as a catalyst for change. And I strongly believe that, you know, on the back end of the experiences, there needs to be action, and there needs to be changes in within one's life and lifestyle changes, and developing mindfulness practice and just helping find positive and sustainable ways to manage stressors and staying more present and just you know, helping the individual finding healthy daily behaviors and patterns within their lives is important. So integration is a huge part of psilocybin mushroom therapy. It's just all the action on the back end that really promotes change.
I know the mindfulness and the spiritual nature of the healing process is something that isn't really in the common parlance of medical technology and terminology these days. One of the reasons why I really appreciate doctors like Dr. Green over here participating in this is that you know, he really brings that medical aspect of this to the process. And I will let him tell you a little bit about his role in this whole thing.
Yeah, you know, I was brought to the space a couple of years ago, admittedly after my personal exposure to the medicine and its impact on myself. And the way I practice in the U.S. With my startup, really how I see the human body, it's an integrated unit. You know, you could say I practice preventive medicine, integrative medicine, but ultimately what I appreciate is that the mind, body, spirit have to be addressed in a cohesive way to allow us to achieve the highest quality of living that we're capable of. And so one of the things we're doing here is looking at how the therapy, the medicine impacts us physiologically. And are there things that we can identify that will enhance someone's opportunity to appreciate maximum benefit from the therapy? Are there things that we can do prior to, you know, potentially a therapeutic intervention to allow them to have the greatest potential for a positive result? And also, are there people that just, this may not be the best for them? And, you know, we need to address other areas of their lifestyle, whether it's, you know, nutrition, things like that, that can be optimized before they start participating in these areas of optimization. Because ultimately, this is just a tool, and the tool works best on a machine that's willing to be receptive for what it does. And if we're not addressing the body as a unit, I don't think we'll be able to appreciate as significant an impact as we could have with this. And so I'm hopeful that with our approach, we'll be able to create a model that can be extrapolated globally because you know we're not doing anything technologically advanced. We're actually approaching this fairly simply, and I believe the answer is always simple. So I'm grateful for everyone's expertise here, and that you know Thomas is a. I mean, it's truth of the matter is we used to speak every Friday, and we didn't really talk a lot about medicine. We talked about, is Thomas drinking water? Is he exercising? Mm-hmm. Is he doing the things that he can do to optimize his physical health? And the medicine is, like I said, just a tool. So I think we have a lot of potential for positive impact.
I really appreciate that the entire team here has had this very holistic and full life experience approach to this. I think that is something that I would really like to see as a service that we offer in Canada. And one of the reasons, of course, why I'm working towards getting our laws changed there, that hopefully this type of service will be available in Canada and in the U.S. as well, eventually. This is something that I'm know from personal experience and from the experience of many people like myself is an incredibly beneficial system for being able to restore quality of life for many conditions. Unfortunately, this is not something that's currently available in Canada, but it is available here in Jamaica, and that's a service that you and your team are able to provide here. If you would like to be able to tell people how they might be able to access this here in Jamaica, and that would hopefully be something that will help you or one of your loved ones.
Absolutely. Thank you, Thomas. Yeah, we would love to hear from any Canadians that are in need that would be interested in joining us down here under our Ethical Access Program. They can head over to wake.net/ethical-access, and I believe Revitalist also has a website.
Mm-hmm. Revitalist.com/ethical-access, same as Wakes.
Well, fantastic. I have to say from the bottom of my heart, I really appreciate what you and your team have done for both myself and for my wife. We are going to be returning to Canada in far better shape than we were when we originally showed up here. And you know, thank goodness that people like you have the courage to move forward with programs like this that are not available in our home countries. So,
thank you for everything you've done for Canada and for people around the world, Thomas. We really appreciate it. So we're very grateful to be a part of your journey, and thank you for doing everything you've done.
Great.